Zdravím a vítejte u dalšího, už třetího dílu. Začínáme z Ostra. V minulém díle nám kompletně vyplenili celou Skalici a hele kopřivy. A nám nezbylo vůbec nic než meč pro kobylu. Takže nezbývá nic jiného než zdrhat. Za náma samozřejmě běží jeden kumán s mečem, zatím ho tam už ho vidím, takže zdrhám. Zase si popoběhnu pěkně, teď kopřivy nechám kopřivama. A tady pomůžu trošku Tereze. Já vím, jak se jezdí na koni, hlavně mě to neučte. Tak, fantastiko, a zdrháme. Teď bude hlavní nějakým způsobem se dostat na Talmberg. Hele, tady je další kůň, ten určitě nepůjde vzít. Game saved. A cutscéna. Pokračujeme ve zdrhání. Vlastně ta cutscéna byla jen díky tomu, aby získal poranění nohy a krvácení. Teď nezbývá nic jiného než... No hezky to tu štípali. Pryč odsaď, rovná taky padla. Výhodou je, že já takhle varuju Talmberský. Utíkejte všichni, kdo můžete, kam chcete, stejně vás smrt asi nemine. Teda nevím, co to máte za koně, že vlastně na půl cesty do Talmberka už nemá prakticky žádnou staminu. No jo, já tě nechám, nadechni si. Ale žádný čekání další teď už. To byl přímej zásah, takže zdrháme dál. Krvácení se ještě zvýšilo, což je super. On pořád k tomu kamenolomu to ještě nějaký kousek je, ale s životem to není úplně špatný. Mně se totiž v jedné herní linii povedlo, že jsem přijel na hrát s jedním HPčkem a zemřel jsem během cutscény. Není jiná možnost, než se vrátit a zopakovat si celou tuhle jízdu.
Someone give him a drink. And bring hot wine and bandages. Tell me, boy, who are you and where are you from? What in hell's name happened?
I've come from Scalitz. They burned it to the ground. Slaughtered everyone.
Who? Who burned it to the ground?
A huge army. They attacked without warning. And they weren't Czechs or Germans either.
Who then?
I don't know. I've never seen armor like it or heard their language. Maybe Tatars?
Tatars, you say?
Yeah.
Well, we'll deal with that later. First, let's have a look at that leg of yours.
I don't know.
Grit your teeth, boy. I'm gonna pull that hair out. Easy. All done. You were lucky, lad. The arrow missed the bone. It only needed bandaging, and I've done that often enough before. War is a good teacher. Can you stand? There you go. Good as new.
Thank you.
If you idlers nothing better to do, get back to work. You'll have to speak to Lord Divish. Can you manage? Sir, this is a survivor from...
I heard, Robart. Tell me, boy, what exactly happened? Did you see the ensigns of the attackers? And were there any more survivors?
Sir, I don't know what army it was, but it was huge. There were dozens of banners flying on the hill above Scalitz. The ones who did the slaughtering spoke a strange language. They burned Scalitz to the ground. But a lot of people took refuge in the castle. I wasn't quick enough. And as I fled, they shouted from the battlements that I should come and warn you.
The soldiers the boy didn't recognize. They could be those Cumans of Sigismund's. It said they came to Hungary from the east, and now they're the core of his army. Sacking Gutenberg must have given him a taste for stolen silver.
Scalitz is a small castle, sir. If Sigismund attacks, they can't hold.
Indeed, Sir Robart. And our small garrison would be no help, even if we could risk sending them.
You think we're next in line?
Maybe. What's your name, boy?
I'm Henry, son of the Scalitz blacksmith.
I know him. Did he make it inside the castle? I'm sorry. It's in God's hands now. No one else can help us. Anyway, thank you for risking your neck to warn us. Robart, take care of Henry. Make sure he gets something to eat and some rest.
Yes, sir.
And get all the people inside the gates. We have to prepare for the worst. Make all the necessary arrangements.
As you command, sir.
No, pokračujeme dál. Na Stalmberg jsme se dostali. Teď se dostat z Stalmberga. A máme tady zase jeden ultra mega dlouhý load. Dobré. Divišem ani s komořem mluvit nemůžeme. Dám dovnitř, mám vstup zaka. Ale vesničanko, tohle si udělala tady i posledně, když jsem to hrál. Vylezla si nahoru, otočila se a slezla si sem dolů. No jo, mě se chce chrápat asi výrazně.
You've done well, lad. I'm sorry for your loss. You must be all done in. Why don't you go to the kitchen and have a good meal? Sorrow is easier to bear on a full stomach.
Proč sakra všichni vypadáte, jako kdybyste se válili hubou v bahně, ale fakt úplně všichni. Co ty? Promiň, ale aspoň jeden člověk. Ne, to se zdá, že se vybarvuje takhle jenom, když přijde na dialog, OK. Reputace ztracena, mi řekni za co, jako...
Ah, milady. You are fortunate our good lady Stephanie of Talmberg has graced us with a presence.
My lady, I'm honored.
So this is our brave young man. Welcome, lad. Božena here will take care of you. No doubt you're tired and hungry.
Indeed. How could he not be, poor soul? After everything he's been through, he must be as hungry as a bear. Aren't you, young master? Here you are, then. Eat your fill.
And a little wine to wash it down.
Thank you, my lady.
When you're done, you can go and rest with the grooms in the outer bailey.
No, that won't do, Sir Robard. After all he's been through, he deserves a proper bed. Let him sleep in a lodge in the courtyard.
Certainly, my lady. Young Henry here is overwhelmed by your generosity.
Yes, yes. Thank you, my lady. May God reward you for your kindness.
Eat up now. You're in capable hands, so I'll leave you to it. Good night.
Good night.
Good night, ma'am.
When you've done, you can sleep in the bedchamber of the courtyard lodge. And don't forget to take off those filthy boots before getting into bed.
OK, ty boty si asi nesundám.
Something to eat.
Je, už jdeme na to, vydrž. Teď si vám sejra, housku, další, tady koukej se na to, kolik tady toho je. Tady je hotová hostina. A Božena si říkala, že mám do sebe nacpat cokoliv, co můžu, no tak já to beru doslova, pokud to nevadí úplně takhle jako u královského dvora. Ještě ty jabka, to jako bez toho to nepůjde. Když jsme u těch jablek, ne. Ty už jsem prodal tam ty v pořádku. Je vesničanka, jestli můžu sednout, to mě nic z toho neláká. Hele, to je kotlík, ze kterého se můžu najíst. A zbylo mi veškeré jídlo, co mám, tak to je bomba. A kudy se od tebe leze ven, kudy jsme sem přišli, jo, tudy vlastně. Takhle a takhle. A můžu si ji vyspat do té chalupy. A můžu tady s někým mluvit? Ne. Všichni zažraný do své práce. Nikdo nic nevnímá, pod koní má ještě víc práce, navíc mým koněm teďko. Tak já si jdu lehnout a bude. Ty jsi chtěl, abych si tady lech a sundal boty. No tak, ale já jsem dutohlav, vesnický poleno a drban. A dej, co udělám. Co to tu je za frajera tady, jako moment, vstát. Nechceš mi říct, co tady děláš, frajere, já tady spím. Ses mě jako přišel zeptat na skalici? Excuse me?
It seemed like any other day. And then I saw thick smoke rising above the hamlet of Rovna. Soon, Sigismund's army were finished there and came for us. The order to attack must have come even before the alarm bell rang.
God preserve us.
Proč je tu dialog, který mám vést úplně s někým jiným a vedu ho s tímhle vesničanem?
They slaughtered everyone they caught and torched their houses. I barely escaped and they murdered my parents.
The Lord have mercy. I'm terribly sorry. May the Lamb of God comfort you.
Excuse me, já bych řekl, že tu určitou část téhle konverzace uvidíme ještě jednou. Zavři ty dveře, ať mi sem ty blbci nalezou. A doufám, že tímhle jsem nespůsobil nějaký extra další bug, o kterém ještě nevím. Tohle byla novinka. Takže spánek do rána. A cutscéna zase s dalším enormním loadem. Toho asi budeme svědky často při tom točení.
Yes?
It is I, Henry. Forgive the intrusion. I didn't wake you, boy, did I?
My lady, no, no, not at all. But what brings you here at this hour?
I thought you could do with a little wine. It's just what you need to help you sleep.
My lady, thank you. You really shouldn't. You could have sent a sermon.
I was going to, but to tell you the truth, I couldn't sleep either. I thought of you while saying my prayers. How awful it must have been for you. I came to offer you solace, to let you know you're not alone.
Thank you. Thank you kindly.
You're welcome. Now, Henry, I know this is all very new and strange for you. But I want you to feel at home here. You're not to worry about anything except getting better. God knows you've been through a terrible ordeal. I know what it is to be left alone in the world. Although your loss is much greater. But with God's help, the pain will ease in time. And it can help to talk about it. If you feel like it.
I have to eat something.
Aha, máme to tu znovu. A máme tady mimochodem další bug, který už je známý. Ten opět přetrvává i na tom peči 1.9 něco. Že občas se koukáme takhle do zdi místo na toho, s kým mluvíme.
You might be right, my lady. I'll tell you what happened. It was terrible and unexpected. The day started just like any other. Father sent me into town on some errands. I went to the tavern to buy ale for Father. I know it's a job for a groom, but I didn't mind. Because my girl Bianca worked there. I courted her a while and we agreed to meet in the evening. But our meeting was never to happen.
Oh, dear boy.
When I'd done all the errands, I headed back home. I promised Father I'd help him with his work and I was looking forward to it. He was forging a sword for Sir Radzi. Father and I always chat in the forge. On that particular day, I asked him if he'd teach me swordsmanship. He said no. He said it's better for a man to keep his head on his shoulders than lose it over some pointless heroism. If only you'd known what fate had in store for us.
Oh.
But Sigismund's horde was already on the horizon, ready to attack the town. I saw smoke on the horizon from a village Sigismund pillaged on the way to our town, which was soon to meet the same fate.
God have mercy.
And then death descended on Skalitz. The gate to the castle was open. The bells and horns sounded the alarm, and the villagers ran to the castle to take cover. They were carrying the few possessions they could grab in haste, and I saw the terror in their eyes.
I can't even imagine how awful it must have been.
I ran to the castle like our neighbours to take cover, but I didn't make it. I had to find another way to save myself. The men on the battlements called down to me to flee to Talmberg and warn you. I was lucky I knew a concealed path around the castle. I wasn't safe yet. The Cumans were going from house to house below the castle, looting and then torching them. They encircled the castle, and it was clear they could spot me at any moment.
May God punish them.
Then I heard a scream. It was Teresa, the mill wench. She'd been caught by a gang of Cuman savages who planned to violate her. I had Sir Radzik's sword, and even though there were several of them and they were better armed, I had to try and save her. I wanted there to be at least one person I'd helped. And I succeeded, even though it almost cost me my life. After that, I stole a horse from them and rode off.
Like a valiant knight.
I'll never forget the horror. It will haunt me for the rest of my life.
That's terrible. How could something like that happen?
God alone knows why he lets such things happen.
Oh, you poor boy. I understand your grief, but God is not to blame for the ills of this world. That is the work of Satan and those who do his bidding. Those who are corrupted by greed, envy, and pride. You must not lose faith, whatever life brings. Fate has not been merciful to me, and my husband either. Although in comparison to the horrors he went through. I was young when I married my husband. It was my father's wish. Divish was a lot older than I, but a woman must bear her lot. Shortly after our marriage, before I even got a look at Talmberg, the castle was stormed and my husband was imprisoned.
Really?
My husband had some quarrel with Sir Havel Medek of Valdek, who decided to resolve it by force. He stormed the castle, burned down the village of Pribislavitz, and killed many of our men, even the old chamberlain. He imprisoned my husband in the castle and put his own garrison there.
That's awful.
I was barely 18 years old, and all of a sudden, I was left alone with Sir Robert. We didn't know what to do. We went to Prague to appeal to the king and sought help from Divish's friends, but all to no avail. We tried for years, but it seemed I was destined to be left alone and my husband to rot in jail in his own castle.
Years, you say?
7 years. That's how long it took before Havel was condemned as an enemy of the crown. And even then, he refused to surrender the castle and release my husband. In the end, I raised the money to pay a ransom, and only then, by the grace of Lord Jesus, did I finally lay eyes on my husband once more.
7 years. And was Havel punished for it?
Never. And after 7 years, my husband returned to me an infirm old man.
Sir Divish seems like a good, strong man.
Certainly, only he has many concerns. He had to rebuild Talmberg. After he was released, the king appointed him Burgrave of Prague Castle, and he was very busy. He had no time for me at all. But at least we were in the city, and there was something going on. And now, we're here.
My lady, you're still young and beautiful. Your best years are still ahead of you.
Would that that were true, lad. Would it were true. But what am I doing bothering you with this? You have troubles enough of your own. I'll go and let you sleep. I enjoyed our little talk, Henry. Good night, and God bless.
Good night, my lady.
Henry, wake up. You don't want to miss this.
What's happening?
Come to the battlements. One of our patrols reported a company heading here from Skellets.
No, dnešní díl zatím vypadá, že bude hlavně o cutscénách. Nevím, kdo z vás mi sem přinesl tu louč, ale každopádně dík za ní. Trošku si tu posvítíme. Jdem se podívat teda, co se to k nám žene. Jo, teď i ta voda vypadá reálnější než na starém kompu. Hlavně se to všechno hejbe svižně. Za všech situací. Právě jsem to zkoušel ještě v Ratajích a ani tam, ani minimální FPS drop nic. Souhlasím s váma, chlapci. A ještě k tomu takovýhle hnusný bouřce.
There's too few of us, and anyway, we ain't prepared for a siege. And if he's really got such a big army, he might not even hold out against the first offensive.
Kronberg's a strong castle, though. It can handle a siege.
The best thing would be to join forces with Scarlet and wipe Sigismund's bastards off the face of the air.
That's probably why they attacked so quick, so we wouldn't have time to join forces.
Aye, you might be right. For sure, Sigismund ain't no fool. A backstabbing swine, maybe. But no fool.
You're right there.
S tím se nedá, chlapci, nic jinýho než souhlasit. A co pak se děje tady? Tady už mezi tím proběhl rozkaz, jak se zdá.
What's going on?
I don't know. It doesn't make sense. Why would Sigismund advance on Talmud in the night? Especially since he's lost the element of surprise after the raid on Scouts.
Maybe it's not him.
Then who is it? The scouts Jivis sent to Scouts to spy on Sigismund. Said he'd set up camp and was getting ready to storm the castle. And Sir Radzig is an experienced soldier. He'd surely hold the castle for quite some time. It doesn't make sense.
What else did the spy say?
Not much of anything. Before they could get close enough, this huge storm started. And you were right. Sigismund has a hell of a lot of soldiers, including all manner of mercenaries. An army like that costs a fortune. Well, anyway, we'll find out when they get here, won't we?
Aye, we will.
Good luck to you.
Halt!
there?
Lucifer and all his minions. Who else, Rubber?
Sir Radzig. What a relief.
Is his lordship there with you?
Yes, sir. He is right here.
What are you doing up so late, Divish? At your age, you need a good night's sleep.
Well, Radzig, you didn't exactly pick the best time for an outing either. In a big hurry?
It was a bit of a scramble, all right. Believe it or not, this tempest is a godsend for me and my men. As my old granddad used to say, better a sore throat than a slit throat.
I'd say your grandfather was a wise man. Your messenger told us what happened.
Messenger?
The lad you sent to warn us.
He's alive? He made it to you?
He's here with me. He only got away by the skin of his teeth, though.
Thank God.
A brave young man. But tell me, friend, how on earth did you manage to get away?
Thank God for this tempest. When it began, Sigismund's Tatars crawled into their holes and left the storm in the castle for more clement weather. We were able to sneak out right under their noses. The Lord be praised. We wouldn't have stood a chance against them.
Would you like to spend the night in Tumber?
No, no. When Sigismund finds the castle empty tomorrow, he might come looking for us. We'd only be exposing you to danger. Without me and my men, he has no call to attack you.
Well, what will you do then?
We'll march to Rattai. It's only a short way, and there we'll have a better chance of defense and enough room for all of these people. If Sigismund should come, better bend your knee, Divish. There's no point dying in a battle that's futile.
You're right there.
Is that boy still with you?
I'm here, sir.
You have courage, lad. That I can't deny. I am sorry about what happened. Would you care to join us?
I'd like to, sir, but first I have to return to Scalitz.
Are you mad? What do you want there?
I can't leave my mother and father. I won't leave their corpses rotting in the street. I'll join you once I've taken care of them.
Don't even think of going back there, you donkey. Are you tired of living?
But sir!
Quiet! I'm sorry about your father, but getting killed as well won't help him. Divish, make sure that lad doesn't budge from Talmberg until things quieten down.
Not to worry, friend. Anyway, he's injured and needs to recover. I'll lock him up here as if he were Havel of Valdik.
I've seen you've grown a thick skin since your tribulation, sir. But thank you. We'll meet again when circumstances are more favorable. Farewell.
Farewell, friend. And good fortune. Give my regards to Sir Hanush.
I will. And good luck to you and your people, too. These are dark times. Move out!
Talmberka doratají kousek? OK.
Men, tonight we'll have triple patrol. Sort out the watches between you as always. And if I catch anyone boozing, playing dice or slacking off, I'll personally break every bone in his body. I want you to keep a close eye on everything nearby. Sigismund will surely have sent spies, and likely men as well, to follow the Scalitz people, now he knows they've fled. Keep your eyes peeled, and report everything to me at once. Understood?
Okay.
Henry!
A já vím, potřebuješ se mnou mluvit, já se potřebuji zase pro změnu najíst. Jabka mi sotva něco přidaj. Ještě mrk. To je taky další dva, hele, máme 8 mrkví, tak to něco nahází celkem. Ať jsem bral ty sejry, housky a je to všech, tady je pečená kachnička. No, ale snižuje odpočatost, čili zvyšuje únavu, nic moc.
What is it you need?
I could use an extra pair of eyes, and yours are keen. Will you keep watch on the battlements with my men?
Is that a request or an order?
I'd rather it was a request you answered yes to.
Of course I'll help. I have to pay you back somehow after all you've done for me.
Splendid! Don't worry. I'll tell the man to relieve you later. Good luck to you.
Tak. Máme za sebou útěk, jsme na Tamberku a čeká nás noční hlídka. Ale tu si dáme až v příštím díle. Já se na tomhle místě s vámi teď rozloučím a uvidíme se u dalšího dílu. Mějte se pěkně a čau!